down to my dad, the water normally being down turning, but for below you cannot tell the direction of the water turning, but when you put a mastic or something light enough, this is going to guide us clearly the direction. We can start this experiment by going at least 18 meters in the north, 18 meters in the south, then we add the experiment exactly on the right. So let's start by north, then we go south. This is north. So here we are, south of Equator. The first part of it involves putting the water into the bowl, first stopping the water from flowing down. Then give this water around to settle. When water settles, we let it to drain down. Right at the moment, the water is a falling object below the Equator. You can see as the drain from the bowl back to the jar, the water is a falling object and it is turning. And according to Coriolis, falling object north of Equator normally fall down rotating clockwise motion. We can see it from the surface clear. See, the motion is clockwise, mm-hmm. And this motion clockwise differ per distance, meaning when you do this experiment a bit more far from Equator, also the motion tend to be a bit more faster. The far you move, the faster it turns. See, the same effect is seen on these vertical tornadoes. Tornadoes, when they blow in the northern hemisphere, they behave the same way due to the same effect, that is Coriolis effect. So that's the first part of the Coriolis effect. To see the difference, we can go an equal distance. The other side, that is down south, same distance. See how it behaves south of Equator now. Now south of Equator. Put the water into the bowl, same we did on the north. Here on the south we do it again. Then after the pouring disturbance, we give it around to settle, then tell the water to drain down. The water again is a pouring object. Now south, still you can see the water is draining down, turning from the surface. The mastic can guide us clearly the direction. Motion is counterclockwise, and this motion counterclockwise differ per distance. This meaning also, if you do it far from the Equator to the south, also it turns more fast. Also, some climbing plant growing in the northern or southern hemisphere, they are affected by the same forces, because some climbing plant growing in the southern hemisphere, they grow coiling anti-clockwise, but on the south and the north, they grow coiling clockwise motion. Well, that is it. To see the difference between north and south, let's go now for the middle, that is exactly on the right of Equator, where we started. Now on the right. Putting the water into the bowl, but first stopping it from flowing down so that you can give it around to settle. Then, let the water to drain down. At the moment, the water is a falling object now, now exactly on the line. You see here, despite the wind, the water is draining down straight. And also, if you flip our indicator, this can show us whether it is, there is a motion in the line. See, on the right, nothing. Try to make it rotate, see, on the middle, on the side, doesn't move. See, it finally set aside without any motion at all. That marks the end of my experiment. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you.
So, normally, after the experiment, remember this, we do got the certificate. This I can satisfy, see, for a long time.
Thank you.
Remind you, they increase the line of Equator. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, you can see there below the pictures, there's a black margin. That is where you write down your name, the way you like it to be on the certificate. Second margin the day, and there at the end of the time, then in the office, there's an official stamp and the signature. And the office normally sells this certificate for only 300 shillings each, where you write the name, put the signature, and the names. So, you can join me in the office. And also, if you don't mind, I'll be awesome.
Okay.
So, welcome, I'll show you where you get the stamp.
Thank you. Do you believe me now?
Yeah, I suppose.